sat on the beach like a couple of old codgers. Right, I've got myself some treats, shiny things. I bought myself a chair, which I'm going to put up in a second, mainly because the one that I had actually broke from underneath me. I got some paracord. I've no intention of using it unless something goes wrong. I got one of these. It's a converter. So I can plug my 230 volt mains power lead into a 3-pin socket. An idea Damon had was to loop the wire round to the AFRI power station so that you can run the microwave basically just by dangling the line out of a window and plugging it into this. So we'll see if that works. I got these because I wanted them. And I also bought a 9-volt battery, which I desperately, desperately needed for the new video mic that I bought. So there we are. We're all set up. We just need Mr. Van Man himself to arrive. Yeah, I might try out the chair. This isn't the one I wanted. I need to go back and change it. I've got a new one. I've also found Guinevere. So let's have a look. They were really, really nice about swapping it. It was actually in the wrong place. Oh yeah, this is definitely the right one. I won't build it now because this is a bit more complicated. There's all sort of bits that are padded and what have you there. So I'm going to put this. It's going to have to get thrown in the van for now. Right, well, I think Rick has just nipped inside the shop, actually. He had a few pieces he wanted to get himself. So I'm going to get set back up and wait for him to come out. And the sweets as well. I'm going to eat those. Right, we're nearly ready to go, and I have set up the walkie-talkie to charge while I'm driving along. I don't know if that's going to... It literally fell over as I said it. This isn't working at all. Oh gosh, that's what I'm trying to do, Rebecca. I'm trying to put this in place. Oh, it might just. Oh, might just put it in there. Right. Okay. So it needs to go like that. Oh. There's just not a space for it. Oh well, I think it's going to have to sit there. I'm not going to be using it whilst driving anyway, but yeah, just sit there and it can charge. So, right, on the road. Let's do this! And we've stopped.
I'm just coming into Swanage now, just crossing the 30 threshold.
Ah, right, okay. In Corfe. So I'm only 5 miles behind you.
I'll see what the parking's like, I can let you know.
That's a good idea. I'll see you in a moment.
Alright, see you soon.
Cheers.
Bye.
Bye. Right, hello and welcome to Swanage. We're here. Although you may have noticed that I'm no longer in Elvis. That's because Elvis is parked a mile and a half up the road there. You can't get motorhomes in here. We have a feeling that they don't like motorhomes. But Rick's okay, so he very kindly came and picked me up from up the road. That was very nice of him. And we're now having some luncheon. So, Chef Rick, what are you rustling up for us today?
Oh, today we have the rustlers.
I really want. So we really are rustling it up.
Yes. Yeah, we're literally rustling it up.
We are at Swanage. Well, we're actually at Studland Bay, just around the corner from Swanage. Rick has gone over into his van to go and get some instant coffee granules because I ran out of fresh. But not a problem. We are going to be having a cup of coffee in Elvis, and then we're going to go down and have a look at the sea afterwards. We opted away from Swanage because it was so busy. We had this idea that, you know, we could come out of season, all the schools would have gone back, and it would be nice and quiet. Unfortunately, everybody else in the entire world had the same thoughts. So, we're here with 3 million other people. But we've come to Studland, it's a bit quieter. And let's get the kettle on, get the gas on first, and we're gonna sit and have a chat, and then we're gonna go and have a look at the water afterwards.
Cheers. This lemonade was £3.25. It better taste of champagne or there will be trouble.
Well, I would just like to say that I've just done a bit to camera saying there was no fish and chips, so we've had Cornish pasty and sausage roll, and I didn't switch the mic on again, so I liked the old-fashioned way, but I couldn't get a replacement wind muff for the you can't see it on the GoPro.
I've got some fur at home you could hot glue onto it.
Now there's an offer. We're going to eat.
Alex has very foolishly left me with his camera. So I was going to drop a little Easter egg on, but I can't think of what to do. But I'll show you where we're waiting. So there's Alex is in there. And that is the seaside. Looks like they're just kind of packing up for the night. There's all the higher equipment. Tide's right in. And we've got this really strong smell of seaweed at the moment. Isn't that lovely?
Now I can tell which camera you've got.
Yeah, busted.
Did you put the sound on?
I did. Oh, some of us remember, you know.
What an amazing smell we found.
What an amazing smell you've discovered. That's from a film, isn't it?
Yeah. It is from a film.
It's from Star Wars.
It is. When
it's
they're
the
in
first one. Yeah,
when they're in a trash compactor.
Yes.
Yes.
We need to get out more.
Yeah. Showing our age here. So yeah, quite often, I think I mentioned this, the last time we were here, I think I mentioned that quite often this beach gets covered over in seaweed. And of course, we've got exactly that happening now. And it is a bit niffy.
Yeah, I'll say. Ugh, yeah. Because I was going to go in there, you know. I was going to put my speedos on. I was going to go in there.
Your speedos on. Oh, that would be funny. And your dog collar as well.
Yes. And some cuffs as well.
Yeah. Could I borrow a camera and one of your 8 lenses?
It's only 7.
Seven, sorry.
You're very welcome. Very welcome.
Thank you. I'll have a think about it.
Okay, office there.
Thank you. So what's the plan now? More tea?
Sorry, this what, where?
Where the peninsula sweeps round.
Yes.
That's actually a nudist beach.
Hold that.
What are you like? Dear, oh dear. I'm going to play the theme tune.
I amused myself. Right, we're now... Well, we're down to the iPhone because we had an agreement that we weren't going to bring our cameras onto the beach, didn't we? Of all the depths people are prepared to stoop to make sure we don't do the same video.
Someone said, I'm not taking my camera.
That's not what...
That wasn't an agreement. Well, I shan't be taking my camera.
Well, either way, so we're down to the iPhone. It is absolutely beautiful. And I just observed to Helen, as it happened, that we were sat on the beach like a couple of old codgers. And, she said, what do you mean, like? Darling, love you. But yes, we are. We're a couple of middle-aged fools. And Rick's getting a little bit of footage for the honest guys, I think. And I might go and have a paddle in a second. So, we'll see how cold it is. Right. Wish me luck.
Good luck.
Actually, I'll just leave the van keys.
Oh, yeah.
A bit rocky.
Better than seaweedy. I'm not falling for it. Strike a pose.
Look at me pulling my chest.
Oh. Good?
Yeah. Seriously, it's not that cold, honestly.
I don't believe you.
Hand on heart, it's really, really not.
All right, I'll go and try it.
I'd like to pretend I was winding him up, but it actually really is nice. It's all right, isn't it? So this is a little bonus feature. Oh, hello. Little bonus feature. Now, most people, boring, I know, keep their coffee in glass jars. But as you will know in the motorhome fraternity, you have to find new ingenious ways of doing this. Sometimes people actually put the roof of the jars underneath cabinets and they screw them on, whereas other people take a more, what can we say,
loose leaf approach.
A direct approach. Yes, we shouldn't laugh at somebody else's misfortune.
The lid fell off. Never mind, we learn.
This really is, I was going to say, you can't hear another soul in the world at them Rick's peaks. It is, it's just lovely. And something's changed in me, because years ago I would sort of be thinking, oh, I've got to get home by a certain time, I don't want to be driving at night. But it is now, what time is it? It's 7:30. I'm still at least 3 hours away from home. But this is... I wouldn't miss the sun going down here for the world. This is magical. And I think this really highlights the whole idea that, you know, sort of seizing the day, taking the moment, because, you know, just like paddling in the sea earlier on, it's far too easy to say, oh, I'll do that next time. You know, I won't do that today. I'll do it when I'm feeling, you know, more up to it another day. So,
I was just trying to describe the ocean. It's not so much waves crashing on the beach as ripples flumping onto seaweed.
Yes. But, I mean, I was just saying, actually, the magic for me is the fact that, you know, years ago I would have said, oh, you know, must go home because I don't want to be driving in the dark, I don't want to be too late. But wasn't it nice just to sit here and, do nothing?
I actually prefer driving in the dark, so...
Yeah.
Especially coming home from here, there's something quite cosy about it, so... and of course, heading the way we do, you'll have the sun in your face.
Yes.
If it's setting, it's like, right in your face. So
I think it's coming from Swanage, there is only one way to get out. So.
Yeah, so it's usually better to wait till the sun has set and then go home that way. But that's it for this video. So thank you, Alex, for spending the day with me again.
That's right. This is the ultimate not doing the same video. You know that, don't
you? It is.
Let's just own it. Let's just own it, okay? So, yeah. So, you first.
Thank you, Alex, for hanging out with me today. It's been good to see you again.
Yes, and, likewise. Thank you, Rick, for your company.
I really enjoyed the day.
Yep.
And that is it from me. So thank you for watching. Have a great rest of the day. And I will see you, well, possibly you, but definitely you, in the next video. Until then, take care.
Say bye, Rick.
Bye, Rick.